Have you ever started a month or a quarter or even a year with such solid financial goals? Like, you know what you want, how you want it, you have it written down, like you're so serious about your finances, and then halfway through or even a lesser period of time, you fall off the wagon so seriously you almost don't believe it? I've been there too. This is probably because you don't have a payday routine. Like, you don't know what to do when the money comes in, all right? So in today's episode, I want to talk about 6 things that you should do every payday to ensure that you remain consistent with your financial goals. My name is Coach Susan, and welcome to another episode of Finance Friday. Exactly is a payday routine? A payday routine is a series of activities that you do every time money comes in. And a payday routine actually applies whether you are employed with a fixed salary that comes at a fixed particular date. It also applies for someone who gets their salary at the beginning of the month, at the end of the month, or even on the 10th. And it also applies to some of us who are in business where your money doesn't necessarily come in on a regular basis. Like, it doesn't come in every 10th or every end month, but it comes in during the month depending on the nature and the kind of business that you conduct. Now, having a payday routine is ideally having a series of activities that you conduct every time the money comes in. So whether your money comes in 2 times a month, whether it comes three times in a month, or it comes once in a month, or it comes on the 1st or on the 10th, you can actually use this to create a level of stability and order in your finances so that you can actually stay on course and crushing those financial goals that you set at the beginning of your of the period or the month or the year or the quarter that you decided that's when you're changing your life. Okay, now the first thing that you need to do every payday is actually close your budget for the previous month and then open your budget for the following month. All right. So what exactly does that look like? Number one, you need to have an actual budget, like a written budget, either in your notebook or in your Excel sheet. If you don't already have a budget, I have a resource on my website that goes for 550 bob only, Kenya shillings. That's a done for you template on what exactly a budget should look like. So what does closing your budget for the previous month look like? Go through where your money went. All right. So how much did I spend on needs? How much did I spend on wants and leisure? How much did I pay debt? And did I actually fund my investment accounts? Like, closing your budget for the previous month is actually accounting for how you spent the money. All right. Why this is important is because if at all we fell off the wagon or something happened in a way that it shouldn't happen, it is very easy for me to correct that and to change it the following month. But if you're blindsided and you don't know you spent 40 G's on food and you only just live alone, you wouldn't know, okay, I need to watch what I'm doing in the supermarket, or you didn't know that you spent 30 G's ordering takeout. You would then be able to pick it out and be like, okay, I need to slow down on the takeout. All right, so that's really important to be accountable and hold yourself accountable for what happened last month. All right, so this can be anything. The date isn't specific. I mean, if your salary comes in on the 10th, you probably need to close your budget up until that point. All right. And then start it from the 10th to the next 10th. If it's first 31st, it doesn't matter. Just have a system that coincides with when your salary actually, or when your pay or income actually comes in. Then now when it comes to opening your budget for the following month, it's asking yourself, okay, how much money do I have right now? Because my pay has just come in. My income has just come in. So opening your budget for the following month is asking yourself this very important question. What do I want my money to do for me this month? So let's assume there's someone's birthday, you budget for that. If it's the month for your birthday, you find out whether your sinking fund had enough money for that, or we are winging it this month. All right. If you need to finish paying off a debt, if you need to fund an investment or a saving account, that's when you plan for that. So don't allow your months to just come and go. And you keep saying that you want to fix your finances, but you don't close your budget for the previous month and open your budget for the following month. So what I usually did, or rather what I do for myself, I usually take myself out on a money date every end month. Yeah, we are still spending some more money, but generally whatever that looks like, it can just be coffee for 300 bob. It doesn't have to be expensive, but I like to take myself somewhere where I can have a sit down with myself to go through my numbers, to look at my tracker, to go through how much money I made in the business, just so that I can be able to account for how money was spent and plan for how I would want money to be spent in the coming month. So try as much as possible to have a money date with yourself every month to do your payday routine, okay? The second thing that you need to do after you've closed your budget for the previous month and you've opened your budget for the following month, the next thing you need to do is to pay yourself first. What is paying yourself first? Paying yourself first is paying into your investments and savings before you pay anything else. We've already done this, guys. We've been there. We've done that. We've promised ourselves that we'll fund these accounts after we've paid A, B, C. But you know, by the time you're done with the list of all the things you need to pay for, there's pretty much no money left to go towards savings and investments. So if investing and saving is a priority, then prioritize that on your payday routine. The moment the money comes in and you've done the budget, first things first, actually take this money to your savings and investments. If you know you're the kind of people that would have so many debates with yourself, like back and forth, do I not, do I? All right. You can also go a step further and automate your savings and investments by putting a standing order with your bank, such that when your money comes in, 5,000 is deducted, goes to your emergency fund. Another 5,000 is deducted to go into your, sinking funds or your stock market investments or even your pension. That way you don't even have to have the debate with yourself because the money is gone already. All right. The third thing you need to do on your payday routine is to pay down your debt. I hope you guys are seeing the order of priority. Money comes in, first thing I do is budget. Second thing I do is actually pay myself first. The third thing I do is pay down my debt. All right. So we want to assume that you've already done your list of your debts, how much you owe. You've broken them down in order of priority. You know which one needs to be paid on a monthly basis, which one can wait, so that you can know in which order should I be paying off this particular debt. My legacy budget tracker actually has a whole sheet where you can actually plan for the debts in order of priority, so that you can actually be able to keep tabs on them and pay them on time. So that's something that you want to prioritize. All right. After you've done your budget, you've paid yourself first and you've paid the debt, the other thing you want to do is now pay the bills, the mandatory bills and expenses, your rent, your internet, transport, whatever it is that you consider mandatory bills and expenses, pay those. All right. Once you're done paying the bills, the next thing that you need to do is to actually now plan for the wants and the leisure with the remaining amount of money. I'm pretty sure someone who's watching this right now already hates me because they're like, what? So my wants and my leisure are coming like last after, paying myself first and paying my debt and then now paying my bills. So whatever I have left is now what I have for enjoyment. For us, that would probably be very little money as compared to how much we are actually spending on enjoyment. All right. So it's really just a matter of priority. I'm not saying you must do this, but what I'm saying is that if honestly having a savings and investment portfolio is important to you, if getting out of debt is important to you, then we will see these things being prioritized in your budget over your wants and leisure. All right. Also, this really gives you a reality check in terms of how much money can I actually, or rather how much leisure and fun and entertainment and enjoyment can I actually afford? Forget what I've been doing. What can I actually afford to do? All right. Once you've been able to do these five things, you can now proceed to do step number six, which is very important, and that is reconciling your accounts. Listen, you want to check on this debt that you're paying, especially if you're paying back a bank or a SACO or even an individual. Please ensure that what they have in their records or in their statement is also what you have. So you also want to have somewhere where you keep tabs, like, I know I paid X amount, and especially if you don't pay a fixed amount. All right, so you could curate your own Excel sheet tracker where you indicate every amount of money you pay off a debt, just so that you can confirm what the statement they sent you said and what you actually have in your record. So you want to confirm your debt statements, you want to confirm your savings and investment statements, because even these guys who work there and update them, human is to error, okay? So maybe they missed a particular top up that you made. I remember there's a time I had made a deposit of a certain amount of money and it wasn't reflecting. And I only was able to pinpoint it because I reconcile my accounts on a monthly basis. So I just emailed them. I also followed up with a phone call and they were able to, rectify that and send me an updated statement with that amount of money that they had missed updating. And why that happened is because I will usually pay via bank, but that time I paid via M-Pesa and I never followed up to tell them this is my deposit for this particular account. That is why that particular top up was missing from my money market fund statement, for instance. So it's very important that you're actually reconciling these accounts. You also want to confirm your checking accounts, or rather your current accounts. How much money do I have in my current account? What needs to go? What needs to stay? Look at the transaction charges. Some of us are with banks we shouldn't be with anymore, because you should not be paying so much maintenance and transaction charges. So bottom line, what we are saying is that you need to have a money date with yourself on a monthly basis, and that's when you do your payday routine. So just as a recap, what exactly have we said you should do every payday? Close and open your budget, all right? Pay yourself first, pay your debts, pay your bills, then plan for your wants and leisure with the remaining amount of money. And finally, reconcile your accounts to ensure that there was nothing that was, there's no errors to the statement, or maybe a top up that you did that was not updated. So as you guys can see, I know it sounds like a lot of work, but for you to actually take an active role in the management of finances, you actually need to show up for yourself. No one is going to come do these things for you. So officially today, I'm commissioning you to appoint yourself as the CFO of your life, okay? Chief Financial Officer. Get these things done. The first month is not going to be as natural. Neither is the second month, because remember, we are unlearning ignoring our finances. We are unlearning just going as the months and the days take us. And now we want to take a more active role in the management of our finances and our money. With time, it starts becoming normal. It starts becoming routine. And that, guys, will really benefit you on your journey to financial freedom. Thank you so much for watching this video, okay? If you guys have any other tips and hacks that you have been working with every payday to just ensure you stay on top of your goals, please comment in this in the comment section down below, and I'll be happy to read them and even to answer any questions you might have. Thank you so much for watching. Remember to like this video, share, subscribe, and so that you can also be notified every time I upload a new video. I will see you on the next episode of Finance Friday. Thank you so much for watching.